Welcome everybody, this is another tutorial video. If I open up my internet browser, I'll pull up the poll results that I posted in my latest video. We will see that everybody is clamoring for some more tutorials. Now, I don't remember every thing that you guys have requested, sadly. I know I am an idiot, but I do remember one stands out, and that is a scene building. Now if you go through my videos, you will see a few of them, mainly I think it's called, we'll just put corrupted, and you'll see this one. Everything in here has been put together in a map, the Black Void map to be specific. And all you see in this video was created by me using various models and all that available in Source Filmmaker and Particles and whatnot. But today, I figured to speed this up, I'd already build a scene here, and it's very nice looking. It came out really well. Before I do anything though, I am using quite a few workshop stuff here, so I'm just going to go ahead and show you what I'm working with. The Nares Sky Card and Sky Dome pack. You get the Sky Dome and Sky Card, and we'll go over to the Sky Dome here, and you can see there are different looks that you can choose. I found that number 3 looks pretty good for what the scene contains. And what else do we got? What else am I using? I don't know. I'm not using a particle grass. The grass that I'm using, shut the lighting off, is a model grass, which is really nice because it's not going to, you know, bog down your system. And you can see that here. I actually had to resize these because the trees that I'm using are small, so I had to resize the grass to kind of fit with the trees, as you can see. Put the lighting back on. So let me see what those are. God, I didn't realize I had so many workshop files, most of them I don't use. Here we go, this is probably the grass one. Pulsable grass, who's that by? Hex. So go and grab that one. That one's good. I think that's it. We're just using the sky box, sky dome, sky card, whatever you want to call it. And I'll just go through everything I'm using here. You guys can just pause and get the names off of it. Keep going. Day and night. I don't even remember I had that. Particle stuff, particles, dark map, I guess, and that is all. So those are the files I'm working with. Now, I guess to make this easier for you guys, can subscribe, I think, to my, to what I use, and that'll download it for you. I think that's how it works. If not, just, like I said, pause the video and get the names. And one of the big things about scene building you need to remember is it's all about what the camera sees. As you can see, let me put the lighting back on. As you can see, it looks, you know, it looks pretty, what, realistic? I think, you know, it's missing maybe a mountain or something over here. And we could use the various rock models to construct the mountain, but for now, this works. And you can see it's a pretty convincing forest. You have some distant stuff, and the light shining, and I kind of lit up the foreground elements to show that the light is shining up and over those distant trees. And what I mean by it's all about what the camera sees, there we go. Again, this is Black Void. It's a big room, dark, that you have to light stuff up yourself. You can get rid of the brick wall, but it's kind of useful to see where you're putting your models when you shut the lights off. But to get rid of that, you would just go to here, and boom. You can just get a good look at the sky dome here, which is really useful for constructing something like this. And I'll just go through, like I said, to save time. I built this yesterday. Now, typically what I start off with are these sky cards. And how you get those is you go to new model, you type in sky card. You can see that's that. I think that's just the sky card. You get the sky card and sky dome with that workshop thing. But the one I use is... let's see, this one. So that's what, forest, sky card underscore forest, and maybe these two, I think. Let me see this one. It's the rounded top, and yep, and the convex, I guess is what you would, or is it concave, I don't know. But it's these two that I use. And those come with different textures. The one I'm using is the black, so they look silhouetted. And that is the number 12 option here on the set skin, as you can see. And I kind of put those around to give, like, build up the distinct structures that I want to use. And then I'll begin with the foreground elements. And I typically throw down this rocky floor texture just so the lighting, if I do have a light, doesn't shine up and through the trees and stuff, breaking the illusion of a forest. So, where is that? Get rid of that. Those are my trees. As you can see, here they all are. These are skybox cluster trees of 8. You got 8 apiece. You can just slap those bad boys down and build up your forest. We actually might want to pull some of those up, you know, like that. Because, you know, I don't like the way that looks open, but we'll leave that for now. Anyway, I think this is the rock floor. Yep. Right there, it's the quarry rock. I just go to the model. New model, and it's one of these, you'll find it. You gotta click endlessly through. That's not it. So you can use some of this stuff for mountains. Excuse me. It's all about going through these models, whether it be skybox models, and even now with the added option of being able to scale models, you have a lot of, you know, options available to you for using stuff as mountains and whatnot. But what is this rocky structure? I don't see it. I have to scroll through. I think it should be coming up. Those would make some cool silhouettes in the distance. Some ominous structures. Here we go. Quarry rock, just like it said in here, and I could have just told you that. But here you go. That's the one I'm using, and you just got to rotate it to make your floor. That'll block out your lighting if you do have a light off in the distance from shining up and through. And then you can see I just placed a big rock here to kind of, you know, break it up. Give it some variety down here. You could put in some animals. I can imagine some animals or some people. You might have to rescale them because these trees are small, meant for a skybox. But yeah, that's all you do. You start off with these sky cards. You figure out your horizon, right? And then you do your foreground. You throw down this quarry rock ground and build your models on top of that, whether you want it to be a house or some trees or whatnot. And yeah, and then I just put this in to kind of help, again, the light from shining through. And yeah, and like I said, you can see in my video some of the crazy stuff I've done with this. Here's those sky card trees with the stars, which are a particle. And you can see I've got this building in the background and all this. I don't think I had, they had the ability to scale models, so these are really far off in the distance, but you can see how with volumetric light you can get like that volumetric, or not volumetric, but that atmospheric perspective where things, as the further out they go, they start to blend into the atmosphere. You get that nice blue over, you know, distant mountains and stuff like that. And here's another clearer shot. You can see I've got some one of those electrical tower deals. I don't know what that is. Some tanks. There's that building again. I don't remember what it was. Some rocks to break that up. And here, all that grass is particle, but you could, for your forest floor. And the thing is, when the camera moves, the particles will tend to disappear because the camera's not directly focused on it. So, the fact that you'll be, where the hell am I? Here we go. The fact that you have that, the grass that acts as a model now, you'll be able to light them up much easier. And again, your system's not going to get bogged down from rendering particles in real time while you're trying to build your scene. And it's all about using your imagination, using what you have. I don't have the option to make my own models, nor do I have time to learn how to do that. Certainly it's something I could do, but I'd rather, you know, just jump right in here and use what Source Filmmaker has to offer. And it hasn't let me down so far. See, this is like a cool thing. It's kind of walking through a foresty road, maybe. And up on a mountain's edge, and yeah. So, scene building. I kind of want this to get done quick, not to be so long. So again, it's all about what the camera sees. Experiment, have fun. Check out those workshop files that I use, and you know, start creating some stuff. You guys will be amazed at what you'll be able to do with just the few, you know, things that are available to you. Yeah, so let me know if this has helped you. Do you want me to go into depth further? If not, let me know. Thumbs up, all that nonsense. If you guys are wondering, I do use a letterbox within Source Filmmaker. I just go to add clip to track, material overlay. I right click on the new clip, show an element viewer, click on the three dots, and the one I use is in that workshop file. I'm not going to show it. You'll have to go back and you'll see it, but I just put 235. And I believe it's the second one, and there we go with our letterbox. There it is with and without. That gives it like a nice cinematic feel. And there it is with a little bit of depth of field. So, again, let me know if that's helped you, and I will see you next week. Well, I'll probably post another quick update on what I'll be doing for the week, along with another poll, so you guys can choose what video you would like to see the following week. So you guys have a good one, and I will see you next time.